How's it going, people? Michael here, and thank you for tuning in to Used Gadgets. And in this episode, I'm going to install a Bluetooth module on my 2006 Mac Pro. The first step is to power down the Mac Pro and lay it down on a flat surface. Pull up the lever in the back to unlock the side panel. Then, pull the side panel open from the top. Remove all of the hard drive caddies by pulling them straight out. My used 2006 Mac Pro didn't come with a Bluetooth module, so I couldn't pair any Bluetooth devices to it. In this video, I will pair my Apple Magic Trackpad after installing the Bluetooth module. This is the Apple Bluetooth module upgrade kit, having part number MA687ZM/A, which can be purchased from a third party, but I will put the product link in the video description. The module has a small plug in the back which needs to be inserted into a socket on the motherboard. The socket is labeled Bluetooth and is located just below the AirPort card slot. If you would like instructions on installing the AirPort card, I'll also add a link in the video description. As you can see, it's pretty tight in there, which is why we needed to remove all of the hard drives. And if you have bigger hands, you could also remove the video card to create more room. And this is why it helps to have the macro laying on its side. Gravity will help position the card where it needs to be. Move around the Bluetooth module so that the holes line up with the screw holes on the motherboard. If you have it lined up properly, the socket on the motherboard will be directly under the plug behind the module. Push down on the module and it will snap into place. There are two very small screws that it comes with, so be careful not to drop it like I did in this video. They are a pain in the butt to retrieve when they get inside crevices. The card only comes with two screws because that's all you're going to need. Mine came with screws that require a T6 screwdriver. It also helps if your screwdriver is magnetized, unlike mine. The screws need to be mounted in opposite corners of the card. Next, take the black cable labeled BT as shown here. This is the Bluetooth antenna. It should be coiled along the top of the motherboard with a protective plastic sleeve. Remove the protective sleeve to reveal the connector at the end. You need to connect this cable to the card. And to a lot of people, this is the trickiest part because the connectors are so small and hard to manipulate, especially if you have bigger hands. Keep in mind that the card has the smaller connector and the cable has the larger socket, meaning the connector on the card must fit inside the connector at the end of the cable. You should feel a click once they connect, and you can swing the joint freely without it disconnecting if it's properly connected. Next, reinstall the hard drives. Replace the side panel and swing the lever in the back to its locked position. Reconnect all of the cables and power up the Mac Pro. If everything was done properly, there should now be a Bluetooth icon on the menu bar across the top of the screen. To connect to the Apple Magic Trackpad, power off the trackpad first. Click the Bluetooth icon and select Bluetooth Preferences. In the Bluetooth dialog box, make sure that the On and Discoverable checkboxes are checked. Then click the Setup New Device button. This will bring up the Bluetooth Setup Assistant, which will begin searching for devices. Now turn on the Apple Magic Trackpad to begin pairing. Bluetooth devices will appear on the list. In this video, it's called Michael's Trackpad. Click the device you want to connect to, then click the Continue button. When the congratulations screen appears, the trackpad is ready to use. And there you have it. If you like this video, please hit that like button, share it, or better yet, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. As always, thanks for watching.